Come on, Aaron.
They've taken British sport to a completely new level, and the winner is the number one, running his personal best every day and being the British.
Yeah,
well
said, Brian.
I think people's the success that we've seen, and we've all revelled in, and we've all enjoyed, and it wouldn't have happened without that investment. And it's not giving athletes money, that's not what it's about. It's providing the infrastructure and the setup to allow them to train as hard as they can, to have all of the best support systems, the best coaching, the best science, the best medicine, and really giving them the chance to show how good they can be. And Britain is leading the aging abilities that we know Great Britain has. So the coincidence of that staging ability that Great Britain
has
is wonderful. And the sporting for them, you know, is changing the face of the nation. I mean, it's an amazing effect this is having. You know, I think the future, the next few weeks, the next few months, we'll see something changing in our society. Because, I mean, have you ever seen so many happy faces all around the place and millions watching on TV?
Oddly enough, I guess this is the one event that people have already engaged in, away from the elite events, the marathons, the half marathons, the 10Ks. It's the access that you have to those events is very straightforward, and it's always great to see so many hundreds of thousands, if not millions of people taking part in these events. But today, too hard in the earlier stages. Kepler Ziggy of the USA, very, very experienced, and Meb will be hoping to replicate his great runs of the past. I think the Americans have actually come here with quite high hopes, and why not? I mean, they've over the years at the Olympic Marathon and in 10,000, etc. Of course, we've talked about Galen Rupp, we've been training with Mo Farah. You know, they've had their own resurgence as well. I'm fairly familiar, or would be, they're running for local clubs in Britain. And you might think, well, how does that happen? Serod Batocia, the Mongolian athlete, he runs for Morpeth Harriers, he lives in Gator, 30 years of age now, and he says, you try running training in Mongolia, much easier training. Hooray for running for Sri Lanka, he's a member of the perfect person on that occasion, so he gets to represent his country, Sri Lanka, here. Now, this is the first beat station, and if you weren't watching the women's marathon, it could be significant later on. Brendan and I remarked at the time how, obviously, it's a long feed station. 60-odd countries taking part here, and you've got to find your own flag, find your own team, find your own personal drink.